morning all. In this video we are going to talk about some terms that we'll use for calculating examples, and we'll look about efficiencies, various kind of efficiencies, thermal efficiency, mechanical efficiency of IC engine. Okay, so first let's recall the basic idea of an heat engine. If you recall our first lecture, heat engine is basically a device which converts chemical energy of fuel into first thermal energy by burning of fuel, and then subsequently we are using that thermal energy to generate mechanical work. So first we are converting some energy over here, chemical energy into heat energy inside cylinder. Then we'll use that energy to push the piston downward, okay, so that we can have some energy over this crankshaft. So the power generated inside cylinder by burning of fuel or combustion of fuel is called indicated power. This much power we are generating with the help of fuel by converting chemical energy into thermal energy, then thermal energy into producing the push over here. Then this power is pushing the piston in downward direction, okay, and piston is connected to crankshaft through these linkages, crank and connecting rod, then we are having pin joints between these bearings. Okay, so power, somewhat amount of power will be lost in these connections, and we will get some power over here that is known as brake power. So power available at the crankshaft is called brake power, and power available inside cylinder is called indicated power. So the power produced inside the engine cylinder by burning of fuel is known as indicated power. Let PM be the mean effective pressure inside the cylinder in Newton per meter square, L be the length of stroke, A is the cross sectional area of cylinder in meter square, N is the RPM of engine crankshaft, and small n is number of power strokes per minute. So work produced by engine per cycle. So in one cycle, how much amount of work will be produced by an engine? So we know the basic definition of work. Work is basically force multiplied by distance. Okay. So we are applying force on the top portion of piston, and because of that force, the piston gets displaced by length L. Okay. So force is equal to pressure into area. Mean effective pressure multiplied by area into distance is stroke length. Of this work done per cycle is Newton into meter, that is the unit of work. Now work produced by engine per minute means in 1 minute how much amount of work will be produced. So we will multiply it with number of power strokes per minute. Okay. So this work done per cycle multiplied by number of power strokes. So unit will be Newton into meter per minute. So this is work done per minute. Now we know that in 4-stroke engine, number of power strokes is equal to half of the revolution. We have seen this in difference between 2-stroke and 4-stroke engine. Okay. Because we are generating power in alternate stroke in case of 4-stroke engine. So 4-stroke engine, number of power stroke will be n by 2. So indicated power of 4-stroke engine is equal to plant divided by 60 into 2. Okay, here we have converted this minute into second. So Newton into meter per second. Newton into meter is basically joule, and joule per second is watt. Okay. So this is the power generated by engine. Okay. Keep this in mind that work produced per second वर्क डन पर सेकंड इज पावर. सो इंडिकेटेड पावर ऑफ फोर स्ट्रोक इंजिन इज प्लान बाय 60. ओके वी नो दैट दिस नंबर ऑफ पावर स्ट्रोक इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल एन बाय 2, नंबर ऑफ रिवोल्यूशन बाय 2 इंटू 1000. वी हैव डिवाइडेड दिस बाय 1000 टू कन्वर्ट दिस वॉट इंटू किलोवाट. सो फॉर टू स्ट्रोक इंजिन इंडिकेटेड पावर इज इक्वल टू प्लान बाय 60. ओके we know that in two stroke engine number of power stroke is equal to number of revolution. So in this case we are not dividing it by 2. So indicated power of the two stroke engine is plan by 60. If we want to convert into kilowatt, then we are required to divide it by 1000. Okay. So this is the power indicated power by generated in four stroke and this is in two stroke. So now brake power, as we have said, power available at the crankshaft is known as brake power and it is measured by dynamometer. Dynamometer is the device used to measure the brake power. Let W be the net load acting on the brake drum, that will look what is W and where it is acting. R is radius of crankshaft. Okay, if you see the equation of brake power, it is similar to indicated power. But one difference is there, instead of indicated mean effective pressure, we are having brake mean effective pressure. So if in example this PMB is given, then you can directly find brake power from this equation. Otherwise, another equation of power, we know that power is equal to torque multiplied by omega. Okay. We all know this famous equation, power is equal to T into omega. Okay, and omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. So you can also find brake power from this equation, 2 pi n T by 60. Okay, now if we want to measure the brake power, then in this equation we are required to measure torque only, torque and number of revolution. And we can see the difference between indicated power and brake power. Okay. We are generating some amount of power and we are getting a different amount of power over here. So some power is lost in friction between these connections. We know that piston and connecting rod is connected with pin joint, so friction will be present over there. As well as connecting rod and crank is connected with pin joint or bearing, some of loss will also be there in the form of friction. Okay, so if we want to find the friction power, then we can use this simple equation. Friction power is equal to indicated power minus brake power, means whatever power available here minus whatever power available here will be equal to the power loss in between. Now, how to measure the brake power? These are the dynamometers that can be used for measuring brake power. We'll see one of them. Rope brake dynamometer used for measuring brake power. So this is the apparatus. It is hatching section is the crankshaft, and on the crankshaft a drum is mounted, that is called dynamometer drum, and on the periphery of drum one rope is wound and one end of rope is attached with load W and other end of rope is attached to wall through spring balance. Okay, this spring balance will indicate how much amount of force acting in this section of rope, and we know that in this downward section of rope the load is W. So now we can calculate the torque based on the equation. First, the amount of load acting is equal to W minus S. S is the spring load. Capital W is the dead weight. S is the spring balance reading in Newton. Okay, it is in Newton. So you can say it is force. Force indicated by this spring balance. Capital D is the diameter of this drum. Small d is the diameter of rope, and capital N is equal to crankshaft speed in RPM, एंड आर बी इज द रेडियस ऑफ ब्रेक ड्रम, ओके, रेडियस ऑफ दिस ड्रम फ्रॉम सेंटर टू दिस पॉइंट. Then we have taken the mean radius, so capital D plus small d by 2, so it will be half of this distance from this point to this point, capital D plus small d by 2. So force will be acting over here in either upward or downward direction. Okay, and we know that force is torque is equal to force multiplied by perpendicular distance or radius. So first we will find out how much amount of load is acting. So brake load is equal to W is acting downward and S spring load is acting in upward direction. So net load will be equal to W minus S acting in this direction. So torque will be equal to this force multiplied by radius. Okay, this much radius is RB. So brake power, we know that brake power is equal to 2 pi nt by 60, this is T into omega equation, where omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. Now in this equation we are having torque and we are having number of revolutions. So we can find out brake power using this experiment. Now let's talk about efficiencies. First one is mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency is the ratio of brake power divided by indicated power. Okay, the name suggests mechanical, means efficiency of this piston cylinder, piston and crank mechanism or slider crank mechanism. So we know that the power available, the basic equation of efficiency is output divided by input. So input to this mechanism is power acting on this piston, top surface of piston, that is indicated power, and output will be power available at this crankshaft, that is brake power. So mechanical efficiency or efficiency of this slider crank mechanism is brake power divided by indicated power. Then next is thermal efficiency. So there are two types of thermal efficiencies: indicated thermal efficiency and brake thermal efficiency. So indicated thermal efficiency, as the name suggests, indicated thermal, okay, so how much amount of indicated power will be generated from thermal energy of fuel. So here input will be heat of fuel and output will be indicated power. Keep this thing in mind. Indicated thermal efficiency means how much amount of indicated power will be generated from the heat supplied by fuel. So here output will be indicated power and input will be heat supplied by in indicated thermal efficiency, output will be indicated power and input will be heat supplied by fuel. And heat supplied by fuel is given by MF into CV, where MF is mass of fuel supplied in kg per second and CV is calorific value of fuel. Okay, every fuel has its own calorific value. So we will multiply this calorific value by mass, so we will get the heat supplied by fuel. Okay, calorific value, you see the unit of calorific value, joule per kg, means by burning 1 kg of fuel, how much amount of heat is generated is called calorific value of that fuel. Okay. We are just multiplying this energy with mass, so the unit will become joule, which is the unit of, okay, unit will be joule per second, which is the unit of power, and unit of indicated power is again joule per second or watt. Keep one thing in mind, that we can take the ratios of the quantities whose units are same. Okay, if you see the unit of brake power, it is watt. If you see the unit of indicated power, it is again what. Same thing is applicable here. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. Next is brake thermal efficiency. Means by amount of, by heat supplied of fuel, how much amount of brake power will be generated is called brake thermal efficiency. So in this case, our input will be the heat energy of fuel and output will be brake power. So brake power divided by heat supplied of fuel is equal to brake power divided by MF into CV. If you see mathematically, brake thermal efficiency is equal to mechanical efficiency multiplied by indicated thermal efficiency. You can verify this equation by simply multiplying indicated thermal efficiency with mechanical efficiency. Next is relative efficiency. It is the ratio of indicated thermal efficiency of an engine to air standard efficiency. Okay, what is air standard efficiency? That we will see in heat engine chapter. Okay. Basically, air standard efficiency is the efficiency of an engine calculated by taking air as a charge or working medium. Okay, so relative efficiency is equal to mechanical efficiency divided by air standard efficiency. Next, air standard efficiency. Okay, these equations we will derive in heat engine chapter. Air standard efficiency of petrol engine is equal to 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. And for diesel engine, it is 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1, rho raised to gamma minus 1 divided by gamma rho minus 1. What is rho? What is gamma? That we will see in heat engine chapter. Next is volumetric efficiency. Okay, volumetric efficiency is basically actual volume of charge served inside the cylinder divided by swept volume. Okay. We know that because of this presence of valves, there will be turbulence created inside the cylinder. Okay, so because of that turbulence, there are chances that what swept volume we have designed, that much amount of air may not come inside the cylinder. So what actual amount of air is coming inside the cylinder divided by designed swept volume is called volumetric efficiency. Next is specific output. It is basically power output, power generated per unit area. It is given by brake power divided by area. Then specific fuel consumption. It is basically how much amount of fuel required to generate one unit of brake power. It is called specific fuel consumption, is equal to MF upon brake power. It is the amount of fuel consumed by an engine for one unit of power production. It is used to express the fuel efficiency of an IC engine. So specific fuel consumption is this, and unit of specific fuel consumption is kilogram per kilowatt hour, where MF is equal to mass of fuel supplied kg per hour. Keep this thing in mind. Here in equation of specific fuel consumption, unit of mass is kg per hour, while here in indicated thermal efficiency, unit of mass of fuel is kg per second. In equation of efficiency, we are using the unit kg per second, while in this equation of specific fuel consumption, we are using kg per hour and brake power in kilowatt. So these are the terms we will use in calculating the examples of internal combustion engines. And these are also important for MCQ point of view. So if you have any query in this section, you can contact me or comment below.